Hello everybody, Nigel with you, Nigel's Modelling Bench. Welcome back, and here we have now pack 43 of the Hachette Lancaster bomber. This is the Dambuster, the B.III, and as you can see, all sealed, unopened, and I believe in this video I'm going to be doing pack 44 as well, but you'll know when you see the title go up, but I don't know because I haven't done the title yet. I think we are doing flaps in this one, so we'll have our flaps hanging at the bottom of our wings by the end of this video. So as usual, we'll have a look first of all in the magazine, and as you can see here, we have the development model there. Everybody comments about it not having a dihedral. Apparently the real one will have, and as you can see here, there is the wing, and it actually has dihedral, you can see from this point. Okay, so don't worry about that. Right, so we're going to be looking at the inner starboard wing flap, so that's pretty cool. So we've got some polycaps and hinges and all that going together, and it's all going to fit into the wing. So raid on Le Creusot, is that how you say that, Creusot? In October 42, Royal Air Force Lancasters carried out a daytime low-level attack on the Schneider factory at Le Creusot, France. So there you can see them all flying across there. Lancaster bombers fly across the French countryside on their way to the Schneider works at Le Creusot. And here we've got a group squadron, a group photograph of number 49 squadron taken in May 45. There we go. Very happy bunch of guys there by the looks of things. And then come over the page, bump bombing. Dropping leaflets on the enemy might have seemed a waste of military resources, but in World War II, it was considered to be a worthwhile tactic. And yeah, it's recently been carried out again, hasn't it? Carrying out dropping leaflets over people in war-torn areas. And Robert A. McCure is a key personality there. A demonstration of how propaganda leaflets were dropped through the flare chutes on leaflet-dropping sorties. You can see there, dropping the leaflets down through the chutes. So there we go. So that's what we've got coming in issue 44. It's another flap. So this, as you know, is issue 43. So as usual, we will start with getting out our parts. So here we go. For those that are wondering, I've had an email to say the Mustang parts for the next part of the Mustang are also on the way. So we have the inner starboard flap. That's a plastic piece. And yes, they've painted the inside of them green, and they should be black. We've got the hinges here, so we'll get these open. And this is the first Lancaster Hachette video with Dottie on board. So if you hear some noises in the background, that'll be her chewing something. She's actually having a sleep at the moment, so that's good. You may have heard at the start some noises in the background. That was her chewing. And I think when I start making a video, just like Jess used to do, she just goes and lays down and goes to sleep. Very strange. Very strange indeed. These bags are a nightmare to open sometimes, especially when you have no nails like me. Right, so we have polycaps. So we have four polycaps, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 screws. 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 screws. So we'll have one left over. Okay, so these are going into plastic because they're PWB. And then we've got our hinges here, R1, R1, and then our hinges there. R1, R1, great. So it's telling us, first of all, take the first hinge and two grips, fit the grips onto the arms of the hinge, repeat to fit grips to the second hinge. So they're going to go on there like that. This is going to be a quick one, I know. They're going to go on there like that. That one's going to go on there like that. And that one's going to go on there like that. So there you go, you can see we've done those bits. Okay. So we're going to turn them over so the R1 is facing up, and then we're going to take our flap and we're going to lay a hinge into there, and then we're going to take this top cap, drop that over the top. Okay, you can see these actual lugs here come right the way through. Okay, so we've got a fairly, make sure it's the right way up, fairly stiff action there. I don't think we're going to have I don't think these flaps are going to operate with an electric motor or anything. I could be wrong, but I don't think they are. So I'm going to put a screw in here. Just give it a couple of turns. Screw in there. Oopsie daisy. As I say, these are going into plastic, so I'm not tapping any threads or anything in these videos. So there's that one in there. So we'll go all the way in with this one. You see, now this is crazy. They've got all this engagement on this screw for these little hinges. And yet, if you remember, when you screw the front of the motor on, front of the engine, you have like one turn. So there we are. So that's our flaps. And then we're just going to repeat the same on the other side, just like so. Fit that hinge on there. Grab a screw, stick it in the hole. May as well just go in all the way in because nothing's moving. Grab a screw onto there, like so. Actually, having these part works to do with dotty around is great because I often have to, I can't get stuck into anything too detailed because as soon as I do, then she starts. And you hear a crunch, crunch, crunch. And yes, the other day was one of my model boxes, which is a bit annoying, but never mind. Right, so we've done that and that's all fitted. So now we've got to take our wing from a previous video and we've got to fit. Take the wing flap and hinge assembly and the wing frame assembly from the previous issue. Identify two tabs labelled R1 on the inboard end of the wing frame. R1, R1. Check that you have flaps with the green side up as shown. Fit the screw holes. Fit the screw holes in the hinges over the raised screw sockets. Fix each tab into place and screw into place as indicated. So that's going to go on like that. So there we go. So that's like that. That's like that. I will be repainting these hinges, these flaps, but I will do them all when they're all in, when I've got all four. There's no point in them. No point in doing one at a time. So I'm going to put a screw in there. And a screw in here, like so. So that's that one in place. And then get that screw onto there. Like so. And then we'll get this one into here. There we go. So that's that done. So that's our flap in place. To be able to put them up in position and have them lowered down. And just as you can see there, there is our completed work. Okay. All right, so looking at this, it's kind of looking like the flap is not going to completely close. When you look at the end of the wing, if you take a straight line from there, it's kind of looking like that flap is not going to close all the way. So we will have to do some modifications, I think. Either that, or they've told us to put these hinges on upside down. What I might do when I go along in a minute, in a second, to step four, to pack 44, I might put the hinges the other way up and see if it makes it better. Either that, or we can actually remove some plastic from here to allow them to go up further. But either way, I will show you how to get that sorted, because you know, you might want to close your flaps right up if you want to depict your modelling of flying. You know, they wouldn't have their flaps down if they were flying in normal situations. So then, that's 43. Let's have a look at pack 44, which again is basically the same. It's the outboard flap. So there's our box of bits. Here we have pack 44. So we'll have a look through the magazine and you can see outer starboard flap. 9 screws, it's like it's just a complete rinse and repeat. So there we go, the flap with the hinges, and what we'll do, we'll have a little play and we'll see if we put them upside down, we'll see what happens. So we're basically just going to go through and do exactly the same as we've just done. So E136, Spirit of Russia, a Mark III Lancaster built in early 43, EE-136 flew more than 100 missions during World War II before ending up as a firefighting practice Hulk. Such a shame how we treated these old aircraft, in it, but we can look back now as sort of, you know, the historical value and the beauty of them and everything. But at the time, it was a war machine and it was a tool that did its job. So there we go. Number 189 Squadron. The Mannheim attack put EE-136 out of action for 2 months. You can see there's all the missions there, or some of them. And then in the air, in the west, 1940. Stukas. Great. Love Stukas. despite the losses of 1,500 aircraft, the Luftwaffe aided German victory over the Western Allies in May to June 1940. They did lose a lot of aircraft, didn't they? Junkers 52 transports dropping German paratroopers in Holland in May 1940. And the RAF's Bolton Paul Defiant fighter had all its armament in a rearward-facing turret. Must have been a nightmare. The pilots trying to evade being shot, and the turret's trying to aim. Oh, must have been an absolute disaster. So there we are. So in the next issue, in issue 45, we're going to be getting the ailerons. So upper and lower. We're not going to do that in this video. We'll do that in another one. So let's have a look in here. Basically, this is just going to be a repeat of pack 43, as I say. But what we're going to do this time, we're going to put these upper hinges on upside down. I thought I felt some metal then. Okay, so we'll get this bag of screws open if we can. So we've got some screws here. Come on. There's our screws. We've got some polycaps. They call them grips. In the modelling world, these things are known as polycaps. They're what you put your tank wheels on with, and generally some Tamiya kits and stuff, you fit ammunition to your wings, stuff like that. Go on, go out. Gravity should pull you, go there. Right, so R2, R2, so that's cool. And then we've got R2, R2. Now, as you can see, what they're telling us to do, we'll fit these polycaps first. Well, these are a lot easier fit. So this flap may well drop its own weight. So what I'm telling you is to do is put them this way up with the R2 facing upwards, as you can see there. I'm going to put them that way. Okay, and that will allow the flap to come further up. And I'm going to push this hinge over the top, just like so. Grab a screw. Get that in there. Then we'll grab this screw, get this one in here. Just like so. And then what I think we'll do, a magazine to one side because we don't really need it for this, do we? That can go on there like that. And as you can see, straight away, what I'll do is I'll get this screwed in. We'll see how this works. Not quite sure I can hold this. Oh, this is really awkward. Try and push the part down and get the screw in as well. So as you can see now, the trouble is with that, I can't drop the flap. The flap comes up way too high. Let's get it side on. Move this one out of the way. The flap comes up too high now and I can't drop it enough. So that didn't work. So I'll take that apart, put it back together, and I'll come back when it's all put on and show you how it looks. All right, there we go. So you can see this one looks like it is going to close, actually. But this one, as you can see, doesn't go up as much. So it's going to need some modification. In fact, I think I'll do the modification now. What I'm going to do is take one of these off. I'll do this now so you can see what I'm doing. There's going to be a couple of ways of doing this. We can sand or we can cut. So what we need to do is this area here needs to allow that flap to come up further. So what I'm going to do is cut here. Now, if you're a youngster doing this, be very, very careful and always make sure you have a fresh blade or a sharp blade. A blunt blade is what will hurt you. Just, you know, if you are doing this, the best way to do it safety wise is to scrape it like that rather than cut it. Or just get yourself a skinny sanding stick like that. This is a this is an icky sticky sanding stick, which is available in Australia, soon be available in the UK, I believe. And that's all I've done is deepen that out. I'll take the other one off so that you can see what I've done. So you can see the difference. No, we shouldn't have to do this, but it is what it is. Come off. Oh, come on. Bloody thing. Right. So you can see the difference here. You can see the difference there. I've just made that groove a bit deeper. In fact, I'm going to make it a bit deeper some more. And it will allow our flap to close. Right, as I say, be very, very careful if you are using the knife. Okay, so I'm gonna basically plonk this on here, plonk that on there, grab a screw. Don't like taking these screws in and out of plastic because sometimes it knackers the thread and you end up with no fixability. You have to glue everything together. Okay, so now, yeah, I need to make that slot slightly wider, but basically you can see that now it's going to be able to come up. So on here, what I'll do is I'm going to chop down the sides with the knife and then carve away the plastic in here and do the same on here. Okay, make sure that it's square, because what I've done on that one, I've made it sort of angled on the side, so it's catching on the side of the hinge, I think. So we can plop that onto there. And then put a couple of screws in. Oh, come on. Slide that up over the top. I have heard from a lot of you, you are unsubscribing from this build. I'll make no comment as to where I think you are or whatever, but some of you have actually told me why. So just be aware, I'm not sure if it's Hachette that do it. It may be other manufacturers of these part works, I'm not sure, but I have heard that in the past, if people start unsubscribing, the manufacturer may well drop it. So just bear that in mind. If you're thinking about unsubscribing and then coming back at a later date, that later date may never come because they drop it. So just remember that, guys. And if you don't want to do this mod, then don't do it. But I would suggest that once you get your model finished, you will not be able to close the flaps. The inboard flaps, it looks like the outboard flaps will be fine. So you can see now it's coming up. It's still not all the way. There we go, it does go. If you push it a bit harder, it goes. Just have to... There we go, so we can get it all the way up now. That one comes up the same height as that one. We can go even higher. So there we go, we may need to modify this one as well eventually. If you do that little mod, it will enable you to get your flaps to come up to meet the wing. Okay, so hopefully that's been a bit of a help. You can see kind of that's where it was before. Now it comes up to there. So there we are. Right, I will see you all soon for pack 45. Maybe 45 and 46 together, we shall see.